So my friend told me this thing I could do while I'm jerking off, where you sit on your hand so that it's numb, and it feels like a stranger is jerking you off, which is pretty good. But what I really like to do is I sit on my dick so that it feels like I'm jerking a stranger off. I'm jealous of kids growing up today, because when I was a kid, to jerk off, you had to like get a Sears catalog and go to the lingerie section. But now with the internet, you can just go right to Sears.com. I'm working on a screenplay. And I got this book, How to Make a Good Screenplay Great, which I think will be really helpful as soon as someone writes the book, How to Make a Bad Screenplay Good. Then I'm going to pitch this movie that I think is a really good idea. It's basically The Santa Claus meets The Santa Claus 2. And I call it the Untitled Damn Mintz Project. So the other day, I walked into this restaurant, and I couldn't believe it. At the same table was Kevin Spacey, Christopher Walken, and Jack Nicholson. And I went up to have a conversation with them, and it went a little something like this. Oh my God, I can't believe all you guys are at the same table. Oh, I'm sorry I bother you. This is awkward. Bye. So I work at this law firm, and every day I come to work wearing a spacesuit, because you dress for the job you want, not the job you have. They say you're not supposed to go to the grocery store when you're hungry. But I ran out of food like a week ago, and every day I get hungrier and hungrier. I believe in the Native American philosophy that when you go hunting, you should use every part of the animal you kill. Like, I killed a polar bear. I used the jawbone to make a knife, and I used the rest of the animal to have sex with. What the world really needs right now in these trying times is for aliens to invade, because then everyone, white, black, Asian, Hispanic, I'll put aside our differences and join forces with the aliens against the Arabs. I'm writing a movie about what if Helen Keller could see dead people. It's called The Fourth Sense. My grandfather was a Holocaust survivor. And you can tell that it really affected him, because to this day, he still will not walk into a gas chamber.